On this video, we will answer this very common question that is asked on a JavaScript coding interview. The ask is to compare two objects, and they can be as deep or nested as they can be. Our task is to write a function to see if these two objects are equal. I will first present three potential solutions to this question, and then will show you how you can present these solutions to your interviewer towards the end of this video. For the first solution, we will do a fast, naive, hacky solution. Let's add a couple of nested objects that we can use as data. Now, write a function that will take two objects. Next is to stringify these two objects or convert them into strings, and then compare them. Let's test this solution quickly. This looks good. A problem that you may see is if these objects' order are not the same, our solution will not work as intended. Let's update our solution and sort the strings so we can cover this edge case as well. This looks better. We can further improve this a little bit more by refactoring, so I'm going to do this quickly before we go to the next solution. For the second solution, we will use Lodash library and let it do the hard work for us. Let's define a function that will take two objects and then use Lodash is equal method to compare the two nested objects if they are equal. You may use other libraries as well if you choose to. For the third and final solution, we will write our own custom solution. Write a function that will take two objects. Next is to do a check if both object 1 and object 2 are objects. Also, check the object keys if they have the same length. If they have, use reduce and set the initial value as true. Then, recurse again as deep as possible if values we are currently comparing are objects. For the last step, we will just do a normal compare of values if above statement is not an object. This might be the solution that the interviewer is looking, as they would want to see how you think, communicate, and walk through your own solution. Recursion is a technique that is not easy to master, that even seasoned engineers often stumble from time to time. Now, it is a good time to go through step by step on how would you present these solutions. Imagine that you get asked this question. Take 5 to 10 seconds to think. Then tell the interviewer, "There are many possible solutions to these questions, but I can think of 3 solutions at the moment. One naive, hacky solution, one that uses a library, and last is a custom solution." Ask which one would they be interested in seeing. If they tell you they want to see solution number 1, then present it to them. Most likely, they will request the custom solution as a follow-up and you show it to them proudly. To conclude this video, solution number 1 may still be a valid solution if we are expecting two objects that are relatively small. This may also be useful for quick debugging or verification of equality of two objects. Solution number 2 is the one that I will choose in a real-world production environment, as libraries are highly optimized to solve real-world problems efficiently. They are well-tested and are written by many smart engineers. Solution number 3 may be good for interviews and to get point across, but may not be able to cover all edge cases that libraries are already covering. We shouldn't reinvent the wheel for problems that are already solved. I would like to give a quick shout out to my subscribers and those who are writing comments on my videos. If you're new to my channel, please take the time to like and subscribe, as it would help the channel and help me reach others. Thank you for watching, and you may click these videos for similar content like this.